Okay, so I wanted to, I know I did the Dr. Jekyll and Miss Hyde thing again, but I wanted to do a tutorial. I wanted to show you guys this look and teach y'all how to do just your makeup faster, a lot easier, and if you have trouble blending or if you're, you know, have trouble with the cat eye and all that stuff, I wanted to show you guys some cool tricks. So if you're interested, hang out, and I'm gonna get started. So I'm going to use smoked topaz. Pink Opal Shimmer, not this one, Pink Frost, and Mocha Java Matte for this look. I know you're thinking, oh my goodness, that's a lot of colors, but I promise it's not super easy to do. All right, so to get started, I'm gonna take Pink Frost, which is called Pink Frost, but it's really not frosty. It's a beigey pink color. I'm gonna use this all over to cancel out any kind of darkness I've got going on or any veins, I don't know, color. I know I have mascara already on, but that's because I, you know, I like lived my life today and stuff. All right, so we've done that. And now I'm gonna show y'all a cool trick. Oh, right in front of my face. Okay, so I'm gonna take tape, scotch tape, well, not even scotch tape, off-brand tape. I'm gonna take it. First, you wanna touch it on your skin and then pull it off. Why? Because you don't wanna pull it off your face whenever you go to pull it off. So you're gonna set this right where you'd want your eyeshadow to end. Try not to get all up in your eyelashes too. So I'm gonna flatten that out. Okay, and now we're gonna get cracking. I'm gonna use a tapered brush and Mocha Java Matte in my crease first. I'm gonna go, what I'm doing is actually I'm gonna cut the crease. So that means that I'm going to stay above my crease line where I can. It means I don't wanna get too far onto the lid. Stay up. I'm gonna blend in a windshield wiper motion and toward the nose. I'm gonna show you the difference between cutting the crease and just doing regular makeup. It's a lot sharper. See how it's like eyelid color. So it's a lot more of a line break. It's more crisp. Okay, now I'm going to take a clean tapered brush with no product on it at all. Make sure I clean up under my brow bone. Clean up over here. Just kind of make sure that everything's nice and blended. Okay. Next, I'm going to take smoked topaz. And I'm going to work it off this brush. I'm going to take that the same tapered brush. Oh, no, I'm sorry. I'm going to take a little pencil, domed pencil brush, that's what they call it. Take it right off the end, and I'm gonna smoke that into my crease. But if you notice, I'm gonna be very precise with the placement. See how I'm just coloring it? Take my tapered brush. I'm gonna blend it into the crease. There are a lot of different ways you can do this. I can take my clean brush to make sure I'm nice and blended up. And the reason I'm using two different brushes, like a clean brush to clean up after myself, is because I'm using such dark colors. And I don't want, you know, dark colors where there shouldn't be dark colors, okay? Now, for that real precise look, I'm gonna take my brush and just really make sure it's nice and crisp. You could do that with the pencil brush if you want to. But you just wanna make sure you blend it out. That's the key to beautiful makeup. Blend it, blend it, blend it. You can always add. Do you feel like you need more? Usually at the end, you know, when I look back, I sometimes will have to balance it out. because I might be heavier handed on one eye than the other. Okay. Now I'm gonna take a Q-tip, the end of a clean Q-tip, and I'm just gonna clean up my lid. Make sure that that line is as clean as it can be. Okay. Now I'm gonna grab my pink opal shimmer. And again, I'm gonna work it off the lid here, or off the applicator with a flat concealer brush, or flat shader brush, whatever you've got handy. But you want it to be kind of small because you need to be kind of precise. And I'm just gonna dab. You don't wanna get too much color here because you want it to be really clean. And I'm gonna actually take this in to my tear duct too. Making sure that that's a clean, crisp line. It was probably the longest part of this makeup routine. Okay, looks clean to me. Now I'm going to pull the tape off. You see, I've got nice crisp line. Okay, next trick is I'm gonna take another piece of tape, do the same thing, put it on my skin, and pull it off. And I'm gonna put this piece a little bit lower where I want my liner to be. And stay away from the eyelashes. Take my little liner brush, working it off the tube. This is Onyx, my black Shadow Sense. I'm just gonna work that line. You stop at the tape. You can go all crazy if you want to. It doesn't matter because that tape is there. We'll stop your brush. I hate putting on eyeliner whenever I have mascara on already. My eyelashes are all in my way. Just building it up. This is a really fine tipped liner brush, so it's really easy to work with. Okay, make sure they're even. Looks like they are. Pull it off. Make sure when you're pulling the tape, you're going to pull up, not down, because you don't want to smear anything. And clean up any mistakes that you have. I'm going to kind of clean that spot up right there a little bit. So if it looks like a weird outtake, it's maybe because I didn't realize that my camera was off. Okay, so moving on. I pulled the tape off. I made sure I cleaned up any extra, anything that was hanging out there. And now I'm going to take my Mocha Java Matte Shadow Sense on the tip of an angled brush like this. And I'm going to do my eyebrows. My eyebrows are very janky. Like, they're not full. They're really skimpy, and there's a lot of holes in them. So I like to fill them in really, I'm not really pressing, just really lightly, just to even them out so that they don't look like they're balding and over-tweezed. Okay. So the last, oh no, I'm gonna do my concealer and all that first. Okay. So now I need to finish up my face on this side because this side is done, this side is not. I'm gonna take my white concealer and my flat foundation brush. Just grab that, start working it in there. Going more in a triangular motion, if you notice, rather than a sphere. It's because I want to bring that down because I want to highlight also. Okay, I like to do a wash of concealer first, and then I'll go in with my foundation, and then I'll go back and conceal anything that I need. So for my foundation, I'm going to use the Color Corrected Tinted Moisturizer, and I'm going to use about half a pump. That's like a third of a pump. And build it up on my brush, and I'm stippling this on here. I've already done this half of my face, so that's why the ratios are off. If you're doing your whole face, you'd probably do a half a pump or a full pump, depending on how much coverage you want. I'm just grabbing a little dot and go up here with it. I can't remember what if I did my chin before. On the other. Okay. All right, now to brighten up my under eye even further, I'm gonna take Pink Frost. Right there on the inner side. And really just where that purple shadow is. That natural darkness that I have, that's the part that I want to camouflage. Remember, light brings forth, so that's going to make it pop out, like look less sunk in, right? And I'm blending really gently, like I'm not, because I don't want to blend it off, I just want to blend it in, okay? All right, so I'm going to take Bronze Blush Scents, and I'm gonna use this as a contour. I just need a tiny dab. I'm gonna use this domed contour brush, grab a little bit of the product, and I'm gonna go right here. Now I'm pressing in, kinda hard. This is a dense contour brush, so it's stiff and it gives a lot of color payoff. If you notice, like, look how much I still have left on my hand. Like, I did not use any. Now I'm gonna switch because it's not blended in. I'm switching to my foundation brush. I have not added any more product to it. I'm just using it because this is so dense. It's best for, you know, putting it on and keeping in that, you know, precision. But when I wanna blend it out, and blend it in with the rest of everything, then I need to blend softly. So that's the only reason I'm switching brushes. Okay. Now I'm gonna use Toasted Rose Blush Scents. This is that mauve-y color that I'm always running for. And I'm just gonna use my foundation brush to take a dab. And I'm stippling it right here. On the apples of my cheeks. I'm not sure if it's a brush hair or my hair. Okay. Okay. Now I'm going to take fluffy shadow brush. This is really that the clean brush that I was using to clean up. It's technically a highlighter brush, so I'm gonna use this much pearlizer. And I just grab a little bit with my brush and paint it on the high planes of my face. See, I also did it down the bridge of my nose here when I did the first half. Then I like to go here. Make my lips look nice and full. So you'll do right here on the high planes of your face, your lip area, up down the bridge of your nose. I do these 11s up here because it'll make them look smoother. Okay, going to powder. And I still need to finish the under part of my eye here. I'm gonna do that in just 1 second. Let me just powder myself up. And I like to use the bronze powder also, just because it's got some shimmer to it. Now under my eye. Under my eye, I'm gonna take Mocha Java Shimmer. Oh, you know, I was wondering if I did do it on that eye. I just remembered a step that I didn't do. That I did on one eye and not the other. I don't even know if you can tell. You kind of can tell. On this eye, I had some Mocha Java Shimmer on this side. But if you do that, then you just go back and edit, because I forgot it before. Not the end of the world. See? Now they're the same. Okay, so Mocha Java Shimmer underneath. And then I have a brush here right there. And then I took Smoked Topaz, that gray. Make sure you clean off the end of your wand. You do not want an excess amount of product. And I'm just gonna go on the outer corner. And just grab a flat shadow brush that you were using earlier and just kind of blend it in toward the nose, very softly. Okay, I'm gonna touch up my mascara because this look requires long eyelashes. I don't know why these ones are so curly today. I think they were touching my sunglasses. I'm wondering if I can fix the shape of them now that they're dry. Oh well. Okay. Just touching up my mascara. Now I'm gonna do some lips. I think I'm gonna do an ombre lip for this look. Right, I know I am. Okay, so the lips I'm gonna do is Love It, which is a pretty peachy color, and Lexi Berry. And ombre is where it starts out dark and fades to a lighter shade. You could even do a third tone in the center if you wanted to make it even more nude. So what I'm gonna do is start with Lexi Berry, and I'm just gonna go around, I'm gonna line them. Gave myself some extra lips. I'm gonna have to, oops, remember that. Okay, so you make a big old line. It doesn't have to be anything clean or pretty, because I'm gonna cover it right up, would love it. Let that dry. Lexi Berry again. Now this time, I'm not gonna line. I'm gonna start on the outside and really gently. Brush in. Toward the bow. And now this time, I'm not gonna try to cover up all that Lexi Berry. I'm gonna concentrate here on the inside. Now, if you give yourself giant lips like I did, you'll take your oops. Dial it down a little. I don't have a towel. So you're gonna have to use my shirt. Wouldn't suggest that normally. I can't leave it there, it'll do well, not feel good. Okay, so after these are dry, now I'm gonna gloss. I think I'm gonna use, let's do opal gloss. All right, there you have it, ombre with cut crease. And some tips and tricks, the tape, huge, huge tip. Makes it a lot easier. So that's that. All right, y'all, I'm gonna go cook dinner. I will talk to y'all soon, have a good night.